Well, welcome to day four of the athletics here at the Universiade in Naples. We've had a fantastic program so far. Two gold medals for the Italians, which has given the home fans something to cheer in the discus and last night as well in the 400-meter hurdles.
400-meters hurdles final.
And the men who are probably the favorites in lanes four and five. Sokwahana Zazini of South Africa and Patrick Dovek of Poland. 10 hurdles spaced 35 meters apart, 45 meters to get to the first of them, with a gold medal waiting at the end. It's a good start straight away. It's fairly even at the moment. Nobody really making much headway. Dovek just being pulled back ever so slightly by Zazini inside him, who's got off very hard over the first 100 metres. Dovek does this, though. He will come back later in the race. Zazini has the lead at the moment. Going well inside him as well is Vega Felix of Mexico and the German Abuoku. The stagger will tell us the real story when they come around. This is where the pole will start to get going, but Zazini has really taken it to the European. The African at the moment has the lead on the outside. Danny Brand, who's been running blind, is also running well for a medal. Although Dovek now will try and come back, but he's not going to get there. The fight's going to be between Zazini and the Brazilian Santos, and Santos is going to take it on the line. The two youngest men in the race take gold and silver. So an historic first gold for Brazil in the 400-meter hurdles for men. 48.57, a new South American junior record, beating his own 48.84 that he set in April. Zazini taking the silver medal, with Dovek taking the bronze. The women's 200 meters final. 2 years ago, it was glory for Italy. That's not going to be repeated this time around. No Irene Siragusa to lift the home hopes. So instead, we have a new champion. The 200 metres is underway, and again it's a blistering start from Dute Chand, but also going well outside her are Wesley, Simon and Skye, and Kwaye. Kwaye has the lead, as we suspected, and she's in front at the moment, but she hasn't won it yet. There's a line of them trying to come back. Kwaye's under pressure, and she could find herself run out of it, and Timonaskaya comes across the line to take the title. Wesley was following her, the German, into silver, and Kwaye, who looked as though she had it in the bag, suddenly felt the pressure. The winning time, 23 seconds dead. So Belarus have the title. She takes it off the hands of Irina Siragusa, the Italian. Simonaskaya is confirmed as the champion in 23 seconds dead, 500s ahead of the German Wesley. Wesley picks up her first major medal. And Lisa Kwaye, who was bronze medalist last time out in the 100 meters, takes up another bronze. Now a new batch of 200 meter stars led by Paolo Camillo, the 100 meters champion, looking to repeat the double that the great Manea did all those years ago. We're away cleanly, first time, no full starts here in the final of the 200 meters, and Camillo has had another great bend like he did in the semi-finals. He's already gone up on the shoulder of Broom as they come off, and here he is again, out in front. Will he keep it going this time? He will. Camillo will run all the way to the line and complete the double. Van Wyk takes the silver, and Lawler, I think, on the inside has taken the bronze. He's been the star of the show for the men's sprinters. And he completes a 100-200-meter gold medal-winning double. Van Wyk completes a silver medal-winning double. And Lawler picks up his first medal in third, and with it the bronze. Could there be another home gold medal here in the final of the women's 100 meter hurdles, where Luminosa Bololio is looking to make it a thumping Thursday for Italy? Well, that cut the tension. This will set the nerves going. Boriolo, again, looking as nervous as she did before the semis, but it didn't do her any harm then. Will it do so here, when the title is on the line? Knocked 13 hundredths of a second off her PB in the semis. Is there any more to come out of the tank?
On your mark.
So once again, they approach the blocks. Italy expects their second gold medal of the night. After Bruni in the pole vault, we're barely 10 minutes later. This time we're away, and Bololio makes a good start for Italy. She has the lead at the moment, but Herska predictably is with her. These two getting away. Bololio is getting away. The crowd is rising, and Bololio is going to take the gold. Herska takes the silver. And I think Conte took the bronze. So Luminosa Bololio takes the title in 12.79 ahead of silver medalist Rita Herska, and Coralie Conte of France completes a very happy medal podium with the bronze for France. Distances start to get a bit longer now in this evening. After all of the sprint glory earlier, we now head for the steeplechase, and the women's 3,000 meter steeplechase it is. This title taken over 7.5 laps 2 years ago in Taipei by Tugba Gurvenc of Turkey, who got the better of Victoria Wagner Gürkiz of Hungary, and a fellow Turk, Özlem Kaya. Seven women have gone underneath 10 minutes this year in the lineup for this year's final. And whilst they not be able to challenge the likes of Beatrice Jepkoege, Noah Geruto, Emma Coburn, who won the last world title and is number three in the world this year, nevertheless, there is a gold medal at stake. Talk about Gurvenc. Back to defend the title that she won 2 years ago. Woman who has world championship and Olympic Games experience. She's yet to really star on the world stage in those two events, but she's certainly a star of the Universiad. Chiara Scherer of Switzerland. Also going, two Canadians, Catherine Beauchemin and Jessie Lacourse, both of whom do have global championship experience at the lower age group levels. We also have athletes from Sweden, the USA, Belgium, India, Ethiopia, two Ethiopians here as well, one of whom was in the 10,000 meters. We'll describe them as they go through this race. Poland, Argentina, and two Australians as well. We have a very demanding starter. Not happy even with the 3,000 meter steeplechase. So then we're ready to go. 7.5 laps, 28 hurdle jumps, including 7 over the water jump. 5 jumps per lap. Each of them nearly a meter high for the men, but for the women here, 3/4 of a meter. And unlike in the sprint hurdles, they don't fall down if you hit them, so you really do have to clear them. Or you step on them and push off. And straight away is the defending champion who has gone in front. Tuk Bagovic, who also was the champion of the under-23s, the Europeans, back in 2015, and she has taken them out and wants to make it a pretty honest pace. Following on behind her is one of the Indians, Jyota Kuhan, and the two Australians both at the front, or near the front at least as well. Paige Campbell, 23 years old, as is Bree Elada. Bree Elada, based in the USA, ran in the NCAAs this year, whilst Paige Campbell was fourth, just missing out on a medal in Taipei at the World University Games 2 years ago. Polish athlete that's going along in third place at the moment is Alicja Koniszek, 24 years old. Has been to the under the European Junior Championships in the past. This is her first international championships, though, in 5 years. So then Guvench leads at the moment, Campbell behind her. Jagadale of India also going along. She's just 20 years old. There are two 20-year-olds in this. Catherine Beecham is the other, but the youngest in the whole field is the Ethiopian Akash Kintineb, who set a PB in the 10,000 metres, finishing seventh around this São Paulo track in Napoli on the first night of action on Monday. Kuvench's personal best, incidentally, at this level is 9:26, so she has comfortably the best time of the women on display, and she'll be looking to make that power and speed towards the end pay off and not allow them to have any chance of sprinting past her near the end. Kuvench was 25 just 2 days ago as well, so this would make a very nice way to celebrate that birthday as they head towards the water jump. Sometimes see the men hurdling all. There's a real accident there for the US athlete. That was not fun. I think that was Rasubala, the 21-year-old from the Northwest Christian University, who has been otherwise having a banner year, fantastic year for her. Times have been crashing down. Unfortunately, it was just her there that did. Just goes to show you've got to get that run up to the water jump absolutely right, particularly as the race goes on when you've got wet spikes and the top of the bar is also wet. Spikes are not exactly designed for going over steeplechase barriers. Guvench, though, still going out in front. Paige is still pretty much the nearest one to her, with the pole. Koniszek also in touch. Paige Campbell, who won the Australian national title this year. She also went on and won Oceania Championship gold in Townsville as well. So she's very much in form. and they are beginning to get stretched out now as they head towards the halfway stage. Being joined at the front now by the Argentine Belén Caseta, 24 years old, a world championship finalist in London 2 years ago. Plenty of major championship experience for the Argentine as well, including a sixth place finish in this race 2 years ago in Asia. She's well placed there, right on the shoulder of Guvej. Well, the Ethiopian has come to the front. Well, Akash Kinteneb, obviously feeling good after that personal best of 34 minutes, 23.99 in the final of the 10,000 metres. And she's gone sprinting off. Well, the halfway stage is now on. Look at this for a break. Clearly, she's full of confidence. Now, is this too early, though? This is quite stunning. Personal best doesn't really exist for her in the 3,000-metre steeplechase, so this is new ground for her completely. She's run a 16:31.61 5,000 metres, which was also a PB right here in the heats of the 5,000 metres only last night. So she's run 10,000 metres, 5,000 metres, and now a 3,000-metre steeplechase. Heading into the last third of the race then. Things are really kicking off, and the gap is not getting any smaller at the moment. Akash Kinteneb out in front and beginning to stretch the lead even further. What will the others be thinking? She's so unknown, the Ethiopian, that they'll have no idea what this Ethiopian is capable of. 2,000 metres in 6:29, so they are, well, they're underneath 10 minutes at the moment. Whatever happens, this will be a PB for her, the third of the week. Oh, she landed heavily there, though. Didn't get much momentum, but nevertheless, she's still now some 20 metres in front of the field. This is quite astonishing if she manages to keep it going, but will the more experienced athletes behind her be able to do something about this? Now the pole, Alicia Konishek has tried to break away from the pack. Guvej, the champion, looks as though she's beaten. She's going backwards and has dropped out of the back of that second chasing group, or that chasing group looking after the Ethiopian. The title is going to switch hands. The Turk is going to relinquish it. But at the moment, who is she going to relinquish it to? The chasing pack do not look absolutely full of energy. And will this Ethiopian be able to come from nowhere and take the title? Not if the pole can do anything about it. They head into the back straight. The Ethiopian is still moving quite well, Kinetibeb. Akash, as she should be known, Kinetibeb is the name of her father. Ethiopians start with their own name. Their father's name is their second name. And Menkir, which is her official surname on her passport, is actually the name of her grandfather. Well, the pole is moving well, Kinishek, but she's not really making any ground yet. The Ethiopian is still going. But will she manage to stay there? The gap is maybe gradually coming down. This is a good drive now. The Polish girl is stepping things up. Kinishek comes to the bell now. And Akash takes it, and the gap is coming down. All of a sudden, Alicia Konishek is moving well. The gap is now down to 10 metres. They've got 350 to go, and it looks as though the Ethiopian is just going to run short of energy on this final lap. Then it will be about whether she can take a medal, but there are two others chasing on behind them. Here comes the pole. She's got it under control here. She's going to take the gold medal. I don't think there's any doubt about that now. The Ethiopian perhaps just went a little bit early. And she loses the lead now with 240 meters to go. Alicia Konashek, 24 years old, coming away to what will be her first global title. They're beginning to overlap those behind them. And the Ethiopian is being caught for silver medal now. Cassetta, the Argentine, is going to come past her. But out front, though, Alicia Konashek is going to come away and take the gold medal for Poland, a third of the championship, but a first on the track there. Gold for Poland, silver for Argentina, and the Ethiopian holds on for bronze. A marvellous result and great reward for the woman who's already run a 10,000 and a 5,000. And Akash Kinetibeb Menkir takes the bronze. Brave stuff. She looks disappointed, but I think she can be well proud of that, as is Konashek. That was a fantastic piece of pacing. She didn't panic when the Ethiopian ran off into the distance at 5 minutes, just believed in herself, and she takes the title away from Tugbar Güvenç, who finished way down the field in this final. Well, the water jump becomes harder and harder as you go through it, as the American discovered. This was the point where, down the back straight, Akash Kinetibeb lost the lead, and Alicia Konashek came away to take the title. Her first major international crown. It was a very fine race indeed. 9:41.47 was the winning time, by the way. So well inside 10 minutes.
Over 18 meters, waiting for the result. Aftermarket best was 17:29. Now it's 17:23, more or less at the same position. She's still in the fourth position, just one step to the podium.
Well, in one sense, Tugbar Güvenç actually serves as a pacemaker through that early three or four laps. Defending champion probably thought she had a bit more in the tank than she actually discovered she did have. Confirmation then of the first major title for Alicia Konashek in 9:41.46, ahead of Belén Cassetta of Argentina, who took the silver, overtaking the very brave Mesut Asmare Dagmar, who took the bronze ahead of Kiara Scherer. Poland third in the athletics medal table here at the 2019 World University Games, behind the Italians and the Brazilians. But the gold medal for Alicia Konashek going with those that have been won by Konrad Bukovicki and Michał Rozmus.